Hello and welcome to this international edition of Horses and Courses. I'm Jean Wood. This time of year in the United States, a little bit of a slow season, but overseas we've still got a lot of great racing action, and we're going to head back through the months of, go back into the end of October and through last weekend's running in Sha Tin Racecourse at the Cathay Pacific International Races, mostly Asian and Australian races on this edition of International H&C. We're going to head to Australia first and go back to November 3rd. A couple of stakes races run at Flemington. We'll begin with the McKinnon Stakes, a Group 1, $600,000, a mile and a quarter, and interestingly enough, on a Saturday afternoon, a prep for the Melbourne Cup on Monday night.
The 12, Miss Finland, at 5:20, ready to go. Set to run, they're racing in the McKinnon now. Princess Coat missed the start a length and a half, and Zipping was going back. And Devil Moon bounced to the front from Anakov, settling down with Pedal of Hercules. Further out, Captious. Arada Sun will settle up fifth early. The fellow Bajiro Valley may be better. Torquete Sermiani. Princess Cope is now picking up ground. Then Railings, Miss Finland back third last. Cynic Shot is last, second last, and two lengths of Zipping last of all. Out to the 1600-metre mark, and Anakov out in front of the McKinnon. Leads out two lengths now to Captious and Devil Moon third the rail. Two further back, then Pedal of Hercules up fourth, a length and a half for Arada Sun. He's getting some cover outside in Enduro Valley. Run and a half further back, maybe better. Covering up Torquete, two then to Princess Cope. Two to Railing, Sermiani, two or three further back, Miss Finland. 15 lengths from the lead, two behind her, Cynic Shot, and three to Zipping last of all. At Chiquita Lodge, truly run at the moment. Anakov a length and a half in front. Captures second, a length and a half to Devil Moon third. Pillar of Hercules fourth, two lengths, Enduro Valley fifth. Arada Sun sixth, the inside, one and a half, maybe better. Then Torquete, further back, Princess Cope, two to Railing, Sermiani, two or three then to Miss Finland. She's a mile back at the moment from Cynic Shot and three to Zipping, about 20 lengths from the lead last of all. They're out of the 850 metre mark, and it's Anakov down on the inside, just steadying the pace. A length in front of Captious, Devil Moon third the rail, Pillar of Hercules, the four-year-old is up running on the outside fourth. They're followed by Enduro Valley. Arada Sun is locked up in the fence and maybe better. Princess Cope starts a run from Torquete. Further back in the race, Sir Leone. Then came Miss Finland, followed by Railing, Cynic Shot, and Zipping is last for home. In the stroke, 500 to go, and on the outside, Captious, Pillar of Hercules going up, and Devil Moon got the run on the fence. Princess Cope is further out in the track. Arada Sun can't win, he's struggling. Miss Finland five lengths from them. Devil Moon down on the inside in front. Out in the centre, coming out of Princess Cope, and what's this down the outside? Sermiani! Sermiani at any odds has grabbed them now. Took the lead from Princess Cope, Devil Moon, then Zipping coming home late. Sermiani has won the McKinnon. A length and a half to second, Princess Cope, Zipping, I think, third. From Devil Moon, Miss Finland. Then further back, maybe better, Enduro Valley, Cynic Shot. Pillar of Hercules followed by Captious. Well back, Railings. Arada Sun disappointing again with Torquete and Anakov near the tail.
Sermiani picking up the victory here. A little bit of an upset. Long shot horse had not been all that successful this season, but obviously turned the tables on a number of very capable runners here, getting the win over Princess Coup with Zipping. Back in the third spot, the winner, Sermiani. A very a big upset winner in this spot for rider Peter Mertens, trainer J.B. Cummings. And obviously this race with the implications for the performance in the Melbourne Cup, leaving things a little up in the air with regard to what was to happen only a couple days later, as this is a prep race, very close, but a prep race, of course, for the very important Melbourne Cup. Sermiani covering the mile and a quarter at Flemington in 2:02.1. We'll head next back to Australia, and once again, November the 3rd, the date for the Victoria Derby, a Group 1 event, $1.2 million for three-year-olds.
Again, the runners ready for the Derby. Vittorio the inside, gates fling back, and they're off and running in the Derby and stockade and marching. Vittorio, they began okay. So too on the outside, Usonic starting to push up towards the front, so is Villain, and from the outside, Bamagira. Best beware just behind them as Bamagira takes it up from Usonic and Villain. Going out of the straight at the 2200 metre mark, a length and a half, Latoria. It's up running fourth out of the straight and outside it marching. They're followed by Best Beware. Stockade the fence from Kibbutz, then came Barrichetta, and the last two down under Boy ridden back today outside at Galaxy Lad. Out to the river crossing at the 2000, Bamagira just a length, now a length and a half in front. front. Usonic second and Villain went up third. Littorio fourth, and then came the favourite marching fifth on the outside of Stockade. Further back in the race then came Best Beware as they go up the back, and Marching's on the move. Marching is going forward, and it's Bamajira from Marching pulling his way up second. Usonic is third. There's no pace at the moment. Then Littorio and Villain is out three deep. Further back then Stockade. Two to Best Beware, followed by Kibbutz, who's relaxed okay. Then Barrichetta, followed by Down Under Boy and Galaxy Lad last of all. Bamajira goes out to the 1450 in the Derby by a length and a half to Marching. Usonic is third, two further back then Villain. He got him to be one off the fence, running fourth. Littorio fifth and Stockade on the outside sixth. A length further back seventh is Kibbutz on the outside of it. Best Beware. Two or three lengths Down Under Boy on the inside of Barrichetta, and two to Galaxy Lad last of all. At Chiquita Lodge here in the Derby, and the leader is Bamajira, but there's no speed at the moment on the outside, Marching second, and they're followed over on the inside, running third by Usonic. A length and a half to Villain, fourth, two for the back, Littorio fifth, and then Stockade. Two for the back at the 1,000-metre mark came Kibbutz. Around it goes Best Beware. Three to Down Under Boy, a length and a half to Barrichetta, and Galaxy Lad last of all. 600 out, and the leader Bamajira from Marching on the outside as they race up to the side. Two lengths further back then came Usonic, there followed by Villain. Back behind them, Best Beware. Littorio locked away on the inside, coming up to the turn. The homeward bound now inside the 550, and it's Bamajira Marching, Villain three out, Best Beware four wide. Usonic is behind those, they're followed further back by Kibbutz. When they turn for home, into the straight they come, Marching and Villain going up to Bamajira at the 400 metre mark, two lengths further back. Kibbutz is running on pretty well down the middle. Marching has got to the front now at the 300 metre mark. He's tackled by Kibbutz. Kibbutz has raced up to Marching and Bamajira. Villain can't go on from Littorio, but it's Kibbutz at the 150 metre mark, drawing a length and a half. He's two lengths in front. Late is Littorio down the outside, but David Hayes, Craig Williams have got the Derby one. They're going to score it with Kibbutz. Two lengths on the line. Littorio Marching third. Villain is fourth. Then Bamajira further back. Best Beware, Stockade down under.
Of course, this is early in the season for the three-year-olds Down Under, and the winner here, Kibbutz, at about 5-1, picking up a little bit of an upset victory here, but a very nice performance as he took the advantage from Littorio and Marching. Marching was the favorite in the field at a tick or so under 3-1. It was a little bit of an upset here by this Golan Gelding. He is a 17.5 hand 3-year-old, a very big horse, a very solid galloper, and one which, with his size, as long as he stays sound, I would have to imagine that he would be kind of an interesting horse in Australia, as certainly they have many opportunities for solid route runners. With rider Craig Williams aboard, Kibbutz covers the Flemington Derby distance of about a mile and 9/16 in 2:40.4. We are going to continue now, of course, with the Group 1 Melbourne Cup, obviously an international event at 2 miles on the turf.
Sharp scenic shot easing in, and so is Sermiata. Down towards the inside, Sculptor away quickly with Tungsten Strike. Dolphin Joe not far away from the speed. Blue Tigeroo goes forward. Blue Monday also on his outside. Marlin's just off the speed in the early stages of the race now, and they're coming along to the 2800 metres, settling into stride. Tungsten Strike has the lead. From Sculptor on his outside second, Marlin striding freely deeper out, got up into third placing early. Blue Tigeroo is behind him. Dolphin Joe handy with Sculptor near the inside, and they're followed by Blue Monday. Just behind those, Doro Valley on the rails, 2.5 lengths to Purple Moon, and behind him is Chalk Heat, and then came Laser Sharp, Eskimo Queen. Next then is Efficient and Bean Bottom, length and a half further back to Autumn Zoom as they come down to the judge at a moderate tempo. They were being followed then. Back behind those is Black Tom, and two lengths away came Zipping, two lengths Master O'Reilly, Princess Cope, and then Sermiota, Railing, Scenic Shot, and Serrera was last of all. Out of the straight now, 2,200 metres to go, and Tungsten Strike makes play a length and a half on Marla, two lengths to Sculpt the third, two lengths Blue Tigeroo. Dolphin Joe's running fifth, being followed by Blue Monday, a length to Doro Valley, a length and a half to Purple Moon, a length to Torquay, being followed Laser Sharp. Two lengths away, Eskimo Queen, and they're followed by Efficient Omazern, Black Tom, two lengths to Zipping. Three lengths further back, Master O'Reilly. He's on the outside of Princess Cape, and then Sermiona and Railings. Towards the end, Serrera on the inside of Scenic Shot. Out past the 1,700, and Tungsten Strike still the leader. A length and a half in front, Marla second, Sculptor is third down on the inside. They're followed by Dolphin Joe on the inside of Blue Tigeroo. A length further back is Blue Monday, Douro Valley the rail, two lengths to Purple Moon. They're followed then by Torquay, Laser Sharp outside him, a length further back in the field. Then came Eskimo Queen. She's followed by Efficient, a length and a half on Azurn. Black Tom worse in midfield. Two to three lengths further back is Zipping, and then came Princess Cope, two lengths to Master O'Reilly. G gets him a long start. Behind him is Railings, and then Sermiona, followed by Serrera, and Scenic Shot still last. It really wound the tempo up mid-race. Tungsten Strike led by Nectar Marla, a length and a half to Sculptor. Blue Tigeroo fourth at the 1,000, then Dolphin Joe. Blue Monday, a length, Douro Valley, Purple Moon, two lengths, Black Tom. Back behind those horses, then is Torquay. Onazern commences a run around the outside. Efficient feeling the pinch. Master O'Reilly ridden along now, and then Eskimo Queen and Princess Cape as they near the turner, and well back is Sermiona, Serrera, and Railings at the end with Scenic Shot on the turn in the cup now. And Marla goes to the lead. Tungsten Strike is gone. Blue Tigeroo and Purple Moon are there. Black Tom is wider, and Zipping is coming with a run. Master O'Reilly got right to the outside. Marla the leader in the cup. From Purple Moon, Sculptor, Douro Valley the rail. Laser Sharp runs on Zipping, and Efficient is coming down.
Again, a surprise here at 17-1. It was Efficient, a horse who had been a very prominent three-year-old, a horse who had not been all that important since the early portion of his three-year-old career, but obviously showed a very strong turn of foot when the big spotlight was on him and pulled out a big, big upset here with a huge late charge. A number of Europeans were involved here, with Luca Kumani, the trainer of Purple Moon, getting the best performance out of one of their horses, with Mahler from Aidan O'Brien's yard finishing in the third spot for the Coolmore operation. But a bit of a surprise as the winner, Efficient, was able to storm past a number of pretty nice horses as they went 2 miles on back on the 6th of November at Flemington. Efficient covering the about distance of 2 miles at Flemington in 3:23.1. We're going to continue now with Australian racing. This is the November 10th running of the Age Classic. This a 6-furlong sprint for 3-year-olds and upward.
The group won the Age. Set to go. Favourite in four, racing Miss Andretti, Gold Edition, both began brilliantly. Gold Edition bounced out in front, stands out behind them with Swick settling down. They're well off the rail. Then came a score and Catachuchu tucking in behind them. Gold Edition coming about 10 from the outside rail, and he's going to change course and go back to the inside. And Miss Andretti is going to follow straight across at the 900 metre mark, and Gold Edition a length in front. Miss Andretti is second. Two lengths further back, stands out and down the grandstand rail. A score leads Swick and Catachuchu. Three over on the inside and down the outside another three, where Gold Edition leads a length and a half. Miss Andretti at the 550 metre mark, stands out about four lengths behind them. Down the outside rail, a score is grabbed by Swick, then Catachuchu. Gold Edition at the 400 metre mark from Miss Andretti, who's going up to her. They're in front over on the inside. Gold Edition, three quarters. Miss Andretti right down the outside. Swick in front of Catachuchu. The two mares come together at the 250, and Miss Andretti takes the lead. Goldie is fighting back on the inside. Miss Andretti a neck in front. Gold Edition fights hard, but it's Miss Andretti. She's just in front of Gold Edition. Oh, she's a mighty mare. Might be horse of the year. Miss Andretti, three quarters, Gold Edition. Six away, third stands out. Then Catachuchu, Swick, and last of all is a score.
Miss Andretti, you remember her from some of the races that we brought to you over the summertime on the International Horses and Courses programming, and went to went to Royal Ascot, performed beautifully there, was given a little bit of time off, and this was her final prep race for her shot hen performance. She ran very, very strongly and pulled off a nice win here. Obviously a horse that has got an international following, and it was certainly nice to see her return with this commanding performance in the Age Classic. Miss Andretti picks up the win over Gold Edition and stands out in 108-4. We're going to continue now in Australia, and this time it's going to be the $800,000 Emirates Stakes at the about distance of 1 mile, this time for three-year-olds.
And they're off now on the Group 1. Shinzig on the inside, and Sonic Quest bounced away quickly. Weekend Hustler has begun okay. He's just starting to make steady ground. When they settle down, Wonderful World is nice and handy. Shinzig, and further out in the track, Weekend Hustler starting to go forward. So they're in a pack in the early stages of the race, and Mr. Baritone was there as well. Weekend Hustler's coming over with Lord of the Dance. They're going up to the front. Lord of the Dance will lead. Weekend Hustler will drive back on the fence second. 2 lengths, Mr. Baritone third, followed by Wonderful World, Shinzig, Sonic Quest a length further back, then Tears I Cry. Then came Ladder the Manor back behind the field, then Bird Dancer, Orange County, Elbrus. Well back on the field, then came Valedictum, followed by Undue. Roman Squire towards the tail, Nick and Nero, and back there with him, Dr. Nip and Tuck at the 800 metre mark. Lord of the Dance out by 2.5. Weekend Hustler comes to his outside, gets a lovely run up second. A length and a half, Mr. Baritone. Shinzig the fence, one then to Wonderful World, followed by Sonic Quest. Ladder the Manor on the inside of Bird Dancer, followed by Tears I Cry as they come around the home turn. And Weekend Hustler just given a crack down the shoulder, going up to Lord of the Dance from Shinzig, then Sonic Quest followed by Mr. Baritone, Wonderful World coming down the outside, and then Valedictum at the 400 metre mark. Weekend Hustler, Shinzig, Lord of the Dance fighting on further out, Sonic Quest coming at them, Tears I Cry on the outside, the Boulders ranged up, then Orange County further out, Tears I Cry has raced up and hit the front from Shinzig, Bird Dancer further back, and then Dr. Nippon Tuck, Tears I Cry in front, and Tears I Cry, what a boil over this is. Tears I Cry has won just from Bird Dancer, Shinzig, Dr. Nip and Tuck from Valedictum. Then further back in the race would have been the outside Roman Squire from Nick and Nero, Weekend Hustler, the bubble has burst.
Tears I Cry picking up the victory, and again a big surprise here. Tears I Cry, 100-1 outsider, sitting off this sharp pace and coming out from the pack and just absolutely exploding here to pick up the win at a very, very big price. Clearly the advantage going to the long shot. We had three huge long shots in here. 101-1, 91, and 81-1. The favorite in the field at just under 5-2 was Weekend Hustler, who finished well back in the full field. So a very dramatic finish to the Group 1 Emirates Stakes as Tears I Cry picks up the victory, the about distance covered in 1:35.1. We'll head back to Australia for one final stakes race on their fall meeting at Flemington, the Queen Elizabeth Stakes. This a Group 3, $200,000 for three-year-olds and up at 1:09.16.
Gates are back and they're off. And Rowan Oakey, one of the best to begin with. See Falou, Lacey Underall. Completion goes straight back. Savit pushing on from Jukebox Johnny. Further back, Reggie, Visvitae a little deep. Further back, Drax back, followed by Desert Master, and last of all, Emerald Jack, out of the straight of the 2200. And going to the front now is C. Falou, out 2 lengths in front of Zavit. Rowan Oakey went up third from Lacey Underall fourth. They're followed by Jukebox Johnny. And out three deep, Desert Master on the move. Further back, then Completion railing up inside Reggie. Visvitae three deep, 2 lengths further back, Drax back, and Emerald Jack. Out to the 2,000 metre mark, C. Falou a length in front of Zavit. Desert Master trying to get in. On the fence, Rowan Oakey a length into Lacey Underall. Desert Master getting in now fourth. Lacey Underall fifth as they slow up. Further back, Jukebox Johnny. Completion's got four behind it. Visvitae, Reggie, Emerald Jack, and Drax back up the riverside of the 1700. C. Falou out 2.5 in front at a fair gallop now from Zavit. 3 lengths, Rowan Oakey, two further back, Desert Master, Lacey Underall the fence, two to Jukebox Johnny, followed by Completion. Then came Reggie Visvitae, caught a little deep, followed by Emerald Jack, and Drax back last of all. 1400 to go to the back of the track, and C. Falou extended the lead, got out about 4-5 lengths in front of Zavit. 6 further back, then Rowan Oakey, followed by Desert Master. A length and a half, Lacey Underall, two further back, Jukebox Johnny. Completion on the fence, two to Reggie from Emerald Jack. Then came Viz Vitae and Drax back at Chiquita Lodge. And Sifalu's gone out with a big lead. Sifalu, catch me if you can by six. Zavit second, five further back, Roanoke Desert Master. Two Lacey Underall, two completion. Jukebox Johnny outside it. A length and a half to Reggie. Emerald Jack followed by Drax back and Viz Vitae last of all. Sifalu has them off a little at the bridle at the 800 by four or five lengths to Zavit, who has to cart the field up. Three further back, Desert Master. Two further back, then came Roanoke Lacey Underall. Completion on the inside from Jukebox Johnny, then Reggie. Emerald Jack further back than Viz Vitae and Drax back last of all. Sifalu to the turn, gets a breather, two and a half in front turning. From Zavit and Desert Master off the bridle, Jukebox Johnny coming into it. Completion is hard ridden back behind them from Roanoke. Then came Reggie and Lacey Underall. Zavit got up quickly to Sifalu at the 300 metre mark. Two lengths further back, Desert Master. Then completion, Jukebox Johnny and Reggie, but Zavit at the 200 metre mark sprints away. Goes two lengths in front of Sifalu. No completion at this stage. It's running on only fairly to third. Then Reggie, Zavit in front. Sifalu tries to rally back, but Zavit. Zavit wins just over a length. Sifalu, three away, third completion. Reggie fourth. Then Desert Master followed by Jukebox Johnny. Emerald Jack, Lacey Underall. Drax back. Viz Vitae back there.
Zavit and Nash Rawiller picking up the victory here for trainer A.J. Cummings as the 14-1 outsider, a son of the very popular New Zealand stallion Zabil, picks up the win over Sifalu with completion back in the third spot. Queen Elizabeth winner Zavit covers the mile and 9/16 on the turf course in 2 minutes 38 and 2. We'll pause now for a brief message. When we return, we'll leave Australia and head to Asia for some racing action, both Tokyo and Kyoto. Please stay with us. Welcome back to this international edition of Horses and Courses. I'm Jean Wood. We are going to head now to Tokyo Racecourse, where at the end of October, they ran the Tenno Show Autumn Cup. This is a Group 1 event, over $2.4 million in purse money, three-year-olds and up, at the about distance of a mile and a quarter.
Oh, so important, the pace of the race. Stand by, they're set, ready to run. Gates back and away. Meisho Sanson began well from gate one. Asian Deputy also. Cosmo Bolt also from gate three. Pressing on is Delta Blues out there and trying to move up on the outside of Cosmo Bolt. Sliding is Shadow Gate. Moving up from 14 quickly as he did last year. Daiwa Meiji into about sixth position. Agnes Arc is midfield. Inside it is Silk Nexus. Then comes Admire Moon. Inside it, Bright Tomorrow. Outside it, Matsuri to go. Underneath it is Company. Then a length the further back to Rosenkreutz. Outside Rosenkreutz is Pop Rock, which is third last. Second last at the moment is Bonneville Record. And last of all is Chosun. They go past the 1,400-meter mark. Leading the way is Cosmo Bulk. Has a one-length lead on Delta Blues. Two lengths further away is Asian Deputy. In fourth is Shadow Gate. Inside it is Meisho Sampson with probably the run of the race. Silk Nexus is inside. Daiwa Major maintaining its position. Then Agnes Arc, a gap further back to Admire Moon, running midfield at the 1,000. Inside it is Company. Matsuri to go, being trapped out three wide most of the trip so far. Inside it is the Bright Tomorrow. A further gap on the inside of it is Rosenkreutz, the syndication mates. A further gap to Pop Rock, yet to make his move, but looks like Pellier started to stoke him up from this position. Then three lengths further back to Chosun. And last of all is Bonneville Record. They've got 450 metres to run. They get to peel off the fence because of the inside is a little off today. Oh, look at the Asian Deputy causing a huge upset middle track. Landau against Agnes Arc, and also took out Daiwa Major. Running on is Admire Moon. Anyone's race at the 200-metre mark. It's Meishou Sampson with his head in front. Daiwa Major out wider, rattling home is Admire Moon. It's still Meishou Sampson, and he's got a length and a half break on the rest of the field and kicks away. It's Takei's Group 1 success. Meishou Sampson close for second. Agnes Arc or Company. Pop Rock late on the scene. There was Cosmo Bulk not too far away. Inside running Silk Nexus.
Meishou Sampson and international riding sensation Yutaka Take picking up the victory from Agnes Arc and Company. This race, an event that is closed to only Japanese-bred horses, and so as a result, we don't have a lot of horses that are locally known or known to the United States, but obviously some very nice international class caliber horses here. Very nice effort for this three and up event. Interestingly enough, the conditions bar geldings from this race, so clearly an event that people involved in the breeding industry there feel is an important event to lead up to a potential breeding career. Meishou Sampson is a four-year-old colt. He is a son of Opera House from My Vivian by Dancing Brave. Bred in Japan by Koki Hayashi and owned by Yoshio Matsumoto and ridden to victory by Yutaka Taki. Meishou Sampson covers the mile and a quarter, the bout distance, in 1 minute 58 and 2. We'll head next to Kyoto for a pair of races, starting with the Queen Elizabeth Stakes. This a Group 1, $1.6 million event for fillies and mares.
Would have been favorite Vodka. G Sweet Tosho's leading right back on the fence. The gates are back. Didn't waste any time. Away they go in the QE2, the Group 1 for 2007. They settle down nicely as they go the first 100 meters. It's Daiwa Scarlet going to the lead. He lets her run along. Asahi Rising up there with her. Road de Colte is there. Versace Pandora. Back on the fence is Daring Heart. In the middle, Admire Kiss. A little back further is Sweet Tosho. Tucked there just outside is Taiki Madeline. In a gap to Dia Delanova, Cosmo Marvelous, Dear Chance, and last of all is Spring Drew. 1,600 metres to run. It's the favourite, Daiwa Scarlet, leading the way, trying to do it all the way. From Asahi Rising, then three quarters away, the back two on the inside, Daring Heart. Outside is Rob de Colte. Running midfield is Versace Pandora. Sweet Tosho is a little handier than normal. Outside her is Admire Kiss. Two lengths to Taiki Madeline. Then further back to Kiss to Heaven. On its inside, moving up now is the aid in Dear Chance. As they go down the back of the straight here at Kyoto, Cosmo Marvelous, Dia Della Novia, Spring Drew is last of all. Kiss to Heaven outside Taiki Madeline. It's still Daiwa Scarlet. Around about the 1,000-meter mark. Forget that pole you just saw because they go up the rise on the outside course. Running second still is Asahi Rising. Third is Daring Heart. Running fourth at the moment is Rob de Colte. Versace Pandora pressing a little closer. Sweet Tosho's had the fence run most of the way. Then a gap further back to Kiss to Heaven. Midfield is Dear Chance. Outside it is Admire Kiss. Trapped a little wide and pressing forward now at the moment. In the pink cap, just obscured momentarily, Dia Della Novia. Back on the inside, the Cosmo Marvelous, Taiki Madeline and Spring Drew. They've got 550 metres to run. Can she do it all the way? Daiwa Scarlet, Asahi Rising. Sweet Tosho pulls back to the inside. Versace Pandora, the winner last year, pulls out the middle of the track. Whacking away back on the fence is Dear Chance. It's still Daiwa Scarlet. They've got to catch her. Versace Pandora looks the only danger. It's Dear Daiwa Scarlet, Versace Pandora, Daiwa Scarlet pulling out all the stops. It's Daiwa Scarlet. Daiwa Scarlet goes on to win from Versace Pandora and Sweet Tosho. Dia Della Novia back in fourth. Then a gap to Admire Kiss. Kiss to Heaven. Then came Cosmo Marvelous. Out wide was...
Dewa Scarlet, another nice performance by a very solid Japanese bred. This race, not a closed race. We did have at least one American bred representative in here, but Dewa Scarlet, very impressive, and a horse that is a multiple major winner in Japan, picking up yet another solid victory here in this event, again at a root distance for the fillies and mares. The winner, Dewa Scarlet, is a chestnut three-year-old filly, did beat some of her elders in here. She is a Japanese bred at Shaddai Farm, offspring of Agnes Tachyon from Scarlet Bouquet by Northern Taste, owned by Keizo Oshiro and ridden to victory by Katsumi Ando. Dewa Scarlet covers the mile and 3/8 in the about distance in 2:11.04. We'll head right back to Japan now. Kyoto Racecourse, the home of the Mile Championship, a Group 1, $1.8 million at about 1 mile.
Stand by. Good luck if you've had a bet. They're set. Racing. Beautiful start from the 1,600-meter mark. They got away well. They settle down after the first 100. Dewa Major's up there early with Laurel Guerrero pressing on the inside. Minor Seagull. Low and Green's in the middle. Laurel Guerrero dropping back. Jolly Dance. Along the fence is King's Trail. In behind it is Koi Uta. 200 metres they've gone, and Lohengrin takes the lead. Outside is Versace Richard, sitting out three wide, the favourite, Dewa Major. Back on the fence is King's Trail. Outside it is Laurel Guerrero. Back in behind him, Jolly Dance. A further gap back to Super Hornet, Koi Uta. Then Pink Cameo, a gap to Tosho Courage. Then Agnes Arc, three lengths away, Suzuka Phoenix. Then a gap to Company. Further back is Bacrux. Outside Bacrux is Picaresque Coat. And last of all at the moment is Sun Valentine. They get to the top with 800 metres to run. Inside Lohengrin, Versace Richard takes the lead with Olivier Pellier. Running third is Dewa Major. Fourth is Minor Seagull. Then Jolly Dance, a gap to Guerrero, Laurel Guerrero. Back on the inside, King's Trail. Super Hornet is there. Parked out wide at the moment is Pink Cameo. Back on the fence is Koi Uta, and Suzuka Phoenix just behind him with Agnes Arc. 400 metres to run. It's Versace Richard, taken on by Minor Seagull. Here's Dewa Major. He has a peep over the shoulder to see if there's anything coming. King's Trail. Here comes Super Hornet. It's Dewa Major. Super Hornet might be the one down the outside. Dewa Major's in front. Here comes the Hornet. Super Hornet getting up to Dewa Major. Dewa Major kicks. It's Dewa Major hanging on. Dewa Major. It's Dewa Major again from Super Hornet. Suzuka Phoenix and Agnes Arc late. Company was not too far away. Then Bacrux, a good run, getting home late. Then came Pink Cameo out wide with St. Valentin. King's Trail was there. In the middle, Jolly Dance.
Dewa Major, another horse with considerable international reputation, a very, very strong son of Sunday Silence, who, of course, one of the most important international sires and certainly the most important Japanese sire of the last 20 years or so, taking over that role from Northern Taste, who was exported to Japan a bit before Sunday Silence. Dewa Major breaking off very sharply and really getting into the race fairly early, as is his usual running style, picks up the victory from Super Hornet and Suzuka Phoenix. We had two offspring of Sunday Silence hitting the top three, as Suzuka Phoenix is also an offspring of that American Derby winner. Dewa Major is a chestnut six-year-old son of Sunday Silence from Scarlet Bouquet by Northern Taste. The name sounds familiar. Dewa Major is, of course, an older brother to the winner of the race prior, with that, of course, being Dewa Scarlet. So, obviously, a very strong family. Worth noting, too, this is a six-year-old stallion still in training at the international highest caliber over in Japan. And I think that it speaks volumes about their purse level that is well worth them, worth it for them to keep a horse like this in training. Son of Sunday Silence from Scarlet Bouquet by Northern Taste was bred at Bai Shaddai Farm and is owned by Kaizo Oshiri, ridden to victory by Katsumi Ando, trained by Hiroyuki Uehara. Dewa Major covers the about distance of a mile in 1:32.03. We'll head to Tokyo, return to Tokyo Racecourse now for a pair of Group 1 events, beginning with the Japan Cup Dirt. This is an event at a mile and 5/16, originally kind of discussed as a possible race to bring more Americans into the international realm. Hasn't been all that successful thus far. We did have student council, however, representing the United States this year. Let's head back to Japan, to Tokyo, and the Japan Cup Dirt.
Stand by. Gateman clear away. The gates are back there racing in the 8th Japan Cup dirt. Pretty even dispatch. Sunrise Bacchus a little slow away along the inside. Blue Concord and Asian Lombard, along with Candidate and Futuroso, go to the line together. The first time with 1,900 metres to run. Well, Asian Lombard caught out a little wide as they went around that first bend at 1,800 metre mark. Does swing across to get a comfortable lead now. Back on the fence is Candidate. Outside Candidate, Furioso. Moving up now is Blue Concord. Then two lengths back to Student Council. Outside line is Cafe Olympus. Then one to Speed. Wild Wonder inside it. In the middle is Field Rouge. Then outside it, moving up on the moment, is Jack Sullivan. Just tucked in behind Jack Sullivan is Vermilion, which a little further back than expected. Then outside it, Bonneville Record. Dragon Fire is fourth last. Just behind it at Sunrise Bacchus, Versace Ho-O and Meisho Tokon is last. Well, they're setting a cracking pace in front at the 1,200 metre mark. It's Asian Lombard from Candidate. Outside Candidate is Blue Concord. Then four lengths back to Furuoso. Inside it is Wild Wonder. Trapped out a little wide, but pressing on now. Student Council, Richard Migliore, looks to have the horse travelling nicely. Back on it inside now is the 11 in Field Rouge. Wild Wonder outside it. Then a gap further back to Wonder Speed outside it. Then Cafe Olympus losing ground. Vermilion starting to pick them up. Caught out a little wide there as Candidate. On the inside, Sunrise Bacchus. Dragon Fire still well back with Bonneville Record, Meisho Tokon. And last of all, can't go with them at all, is Versace Ho-O. 600 metres to run. It's Asian Lombard with Candidate. Candidate really putting it to Asian Lombard. Outside then him is still Versace Concord. Along the inside now, moving up, that is Wild Wonder. Wild Wonder could be the one. It gets down to about the 350 metre mark at the moment. Here they come down the outside, and here's Vermilion putting in the big ones down the centre with Meisho Tokon. Vermilion and also Blue Concord is still there, whacking away is the 11 in Field Rouge and Vermilion. Field Rouge, Vermilion kicks away at the 100. Vermilion, the favourite, goes on, and it's the fourth Japan Cup dirt for jockey Yutaka Take. Field Rouge second, Sunrise Bacchus third, then Meisho Tokon, Wild Wonder. A gap further back to getting home late was the 12, in fact, in Dragon Fire late on this.
Vermilion picking up a win, another horse that we've seen on a number of editions of the International Horses and Courses this year. This is a horse that has travelled considerably and been returned now to his native Japan, a five-year-old, picking up yet another important win here. Most of the major races in Japan are, in fact, run on the turf. They do run a couple of them on the dirt, as, of course, this one was, and a nice performance by Vermilion to pick up the win over Field Rouge with yet another Japanese-bred Sunrise Bacchus back in the third spot. Interestingly enough, some familiar sires in the top three: El Condor Pasa, the sire of Vermilion; Hennessy, the sire of Sunrise Bacchus, of course, a very well-known American stallion. The winner of Vermilion is a five-year-old dark Bayer Brown son of El Condor Pasa from Scarlet Lady by Sunday Silence. Bred by the Northern Farm and owned by Sunday Racing Company Limited and trained by Sei Ishizaka, ridden to victory by Yutaka Take, Vermilion covers the about distance of a mile and 5/16 in 2:06 and 3. Back onto the turf now for the Grade 1 or Group 1 Japan Cup turf.
Stand by for the 27th running. Gates are back. They're away. Papal Bull missed it badly. Getting away on the inside was Pop Rockwell. Cosmo Bolt commenced well. Down the middle of the field, quickly stretching out now is Versace Pandora. Out wider and moving up is Delta Blues. Along the inside is Chosun. Accelerating on the outside of Admire Moon. Cosmo Bolt, they squeeze up a little on the first corner. Chosun a little bit out wider at the moment. Along the inside is Pop Rock up there, nice and handy, and he's getting slightly pulled back there by Pellier, but Chosun goes to the lead from Cosmo Bulk. Pop Rock runs third. Running on the outside of it, moving up quickly now is Versace Pandora running fourth. Then Admire Moon. Then a gap to Delta Blues. Half to Artiste Royal. Then another three quarters to Hiroboko Royal. Meisho Sampson runs midfield. Outside it is Halicarnassus. Back on the inside of Halicarnassus is Victory. Then comes Dream Passport. Inti Raimi moving up. Back on the inside of Inti Raimi. In fact, that's Rosenkreutz moving up out three wide. Then Sadex. Edimo Harrier is third last. Papal of all is second last. And Vodka at the 1,400 metres is last at all. They're still running along nicely. Not too much change in the order. In fact, slowed them down a little bit down the back straight. It's Chosun leading the way at the 1,200 metre mark. from Cosmo Bulk. Running third is Versace Pandora. Pop Rock runs fourth. Delta Blues runs fifth. On the inside is Admire Moon. Then Artiste Royal trapped out. Little wide is Hitoboka Royal. Then comes Meisho Samson trying to run into it now as he's still running midfield with Yutaketake. Back on the inside is Inti Raimi. Victory is in the middle. Rosenkreutz out a little wider at the moment. Eddie Moe, how are you there at the moment? And now starting to make up some ground is Pagel Ball. Dream Passport still well back with Inti Raimi and also Vodka last of all. 650 to run. It's still Chosun showing the way. Looming up on the outside of Versace Pandora, Cosmo Bulk. Meisho Samson right down the middle of the track for Versace Pandora and Artiste Royal. Well, there's a number of chances at the 400. Meisho Samson down the middle of the track, still whacking away is Versace Pandora. Artiste Royal and Pop Rock getting through late, and here's Vodka. Vodka looms up on the outside of Meisho Samson. Meisho Samson, and along the inside is Admire Moon. Admire Moon's got his head in front. Admire Moon stretching out, going to the line. Admire Moon and out wide. Pop Rock hit the line. Admire Moon, Pop Rock, Meisho Samson, then Vodka. Late on the scene was perhaps Inti Raimi, or no, in fact it was Delta Blues.
Admire Moon, again, another one of these horses that has just run so many big, important races overseas. And this race really did feature a number of major performances, including horses like Pop Rock, who had been so sensational in both Japan and in Australia. Vodka, a three-year-old filly, who really was in very good form and who I thought ran a huge race to finish in the fourth spot. Fusaichi Pandora, who we've seen in a number of major races as well. But Admire Moon, another one of those horses that just seems to continue to run good race after good race at the age of four, continues to run well and represent his native country very well. I would not be at all surprised to see this horse turning up over the winter time in Dubai and possibly looking for another big effort from the Japanese horses in Dubai with the likes of Admire Moon. Interesting pedigree on Admire Moon. He was sired by N-Sweep, who of course we remember as one of those very fast out of the block early two-year-old stallions. He was exported to Japan, where unfortunately he died not that long after. He only had one or two crops, if I'm not mistaken, in Japan. But how interesting to note that despite being well reputed as a speed sire, his one of his most notable offspring, Admire Moon, is best known for his rooting on the turf. Admire Moon by N-Sweep from My Katie's by Sunday Silence was bred by the Northern Farm and is owned by Darley Japan, trained by Hiroyoshi Matsuda and ridden to victory by Yasunari Iwata. Admire Moon, who has now got a career mark of 10 wins from 17 starts, covers the mile and a half about distance once again in 2:24.3. We'll pause now for one more brief message, and when we return, we'll be taking a look at the races of the Cathay Pacific International Hong Kong Cup. Terrific series of four races run last weekend at Sha Tin. Thank you. Welcome back to this international edition of Horses and Courses. We're going to finish things up at Sha Tin Racecourse, where last weekend they ran a terrific series of four international events. We'll kick things off with the Cathay Pacific Hong Kong International Sprint.
And they're boxed now for the Cathay Pacific International Sprint. The crowd gives them a tremendous roar. Away they go. Green Birdie's taken straight back to last. And deep out, Miss Andretti's ridden for speed. So is YB, Sunny Singh, Ben Bourne near the inside, and Royal Delight's going for. There's plenty of speed. And Shane Dye takes Royal Delight to the front of the first corner. YB circling the field, going to second. Sunny Singh third, Ben Bourne fourth, and Miss Andretti's right with them with Desert Lord. Absolute Champion parks off the speed. Then Scintillation, Sacred Kingdom. He's got horses on his outside. Sunny Power and Teaser improving. Then Marchand d'Or and Green Birdie is last. Racing to the bend. It's Royal Delight in front from Ben Bourne. Desert Lord's out three wide. Miss Andretti's four wide, and five wide is YB. Sunny Singh behind them. Sacred Kingdom's giving away four lengths. It's Royal Delight in front. Absolute Champion's coming hard. Now Sacred Kingdom's into the clear. Miss Andretti can't go with them. Sacred Kingdom charges up on the outside. He hits the lead from Royal Delight. Absolute Champion staying on doggedly, but Sacred Kingdom, he is world class. Sacred Kingdom's roaring away to beat Absolute Champion. Royal Delight third, Sunny Power fourth, and Scintillation. Marchand d'Or's run with...
Sacred Kingdom picking up the victory here under Gerald Moss in a very impressive performance, I have to say, stamping himself as the best sprinting turf horse in the world, getting the win over Absolute Champion, who was looking to win this 2 years in a row, couldn't quite do it. Royal Delight completes the order of the top three. Sacred Kingdom, Australian-bred son of Encosta de Lago, an international stallion of some repute from the Dam Courtroom Sweetie. Very solid performance here again, marking himself as the horse who has to be considered the best sprinter on grass anywhere in the world. Picks up the win over a very good field of horses. Quite disappointing in here was Miss Andretti. We saw her early in the program. Her prep race, very solid. Perhaps the travel of the season has just caught up to Miss Andretti. Also disappointing in here was Ben Bond, who has quite the reputation as another very good sprinter. Could not hold his own with this group, finishing up the track in the last spot. Sacred Kingdom, under Gerald Moss, picks up the victory. Six furlongs in 108 and 2. We'll continue now in Hong Kong with the running of the Cathay Pacific Hong Kong Vase. Older horses, Group 1 company, $1.8 million at a mile and a half.
Now they're all in. The field is ready and the starter says go in the Vase. Away they go, and Hawke's Bay and Viva Macau from their wide draws are showing plenty of speed, and they're both backing a beeline towards the rails. The Sony's out nicely into third, and Dr. Dino's right up on the speed. Red Rocks is coming across, but caught a bit deep in the early part, says McLear out very deep. Then Co-Cab from Kijano, Vital King Egerton, Dylan Thomas is back third last, just pulling a little bit on the fence, and at the tail of the field is Everbright and also Arch Rebel. At the post the first time, and Beatman takes Viva Macau to the front, steadies the pace out by two lengths on Hawke's Bay. The Sony in third, Dr. Dino's fourth on the rails. Red Rocks is coursing deep, turning out of the straight on the outside of Co-Cab, and Kijano on the yellow colours pinned back on the fence. Deep route is Vital King. McLear's going forward. Right off the track, McLear, but has been committed to improving her position, the German mare, as they go to the back. Further back in the race to Dylan Thomas from Everbright, and Arch Rebels at the tail of the field. They're going a fairly steady gallop here, and McLear's been able to come from last, and Moore has circled the field on McLear and goes up to eyeball Viva Macau. The Sony splits the pair in third. Hawke's Bay with cover. Red Rocks is off the track on the outside of Co-Cab. A length further back to Vital King, who's covering the ground around Egerton, and Dr. Dino on the rails. Then Kijano from Everbright, Dylan Thomas, and a length and a half off to Arch Rebel at the tail of the field. They've been going a steady gallop right from the outset, and McLear went right around the field and leads at the halfway mark. Out by a length to Viva Macau and Bassoni. Right right off the course there, but continuing to bat on is Red Rocks on the outside of Co-Cab, then Hawksbow on the rails. Further back to Vital King from Megadon being shaken up. Then Dr. Dino from Everbright, Kajano. Motors, but well back in the field here on the short price favourite, Dylan Thomas, but staying to the fence for the moment. And Arch Rebel is last as they start to quicken the tempo. Coming to the turn, it's McLayer in front from Bassani getting closer, and Red Rocks the outside. Then Viva Macau from Co-Cab. Vital King's placed under some pressure from Hawke's Bay Egerton. Everbright's pulling to the outside together with Kajano, and Dylan Thomas gives them a big start as they're well into the straight. And Christoph Sumion takes Bassani clear from Red Rocks. Egerton's running on. Then Dr. Dino and Kajano the outside. Bassani leads inside the 150, but Dr. Dino's coming hard. Dr. Dino raced up to Bassani. Kajano the outside, but Dr. Dino's coming away for Pellier. Dr. Dino from Kajano and Bassani. Arch Rebel fourth, followed in by Co-Cab Egerton. Dylan Thomas couldn't pick them up.
Dr. Dino, a horse that we saw not only on this international edition of Horses and Courses a couple of times, but right here in the United States, the winner of the Man of War. They decided to take a pass on the Breeders' Cup. They weren't interested in paying the fees in order to make this horse eligible, and as a result, they decided to head to Hong Kong and picked up a very impressive victory over Kihano, who was an impressive German bred, a horse that had run extremely well over last winter during the course of the International Racing Carnival in Dubai, traveled back to Europe, and then heads over to Asia to run a big second here under Andreas Stark, and Bussoni, another German bred, completing the order of the top three. A little bit of a surprise in here was the disappointing effort by Dylan Thomas, who ran seventh. Obviously a horse that has had a very, very stressful season. He has been all over the place. Decided to, they were actually aiming for the Japan Cup with this horse. They did have a problem with quarantine. Horse ended up instead going to Hong Kong. Was certainly given every opportunity to perform well, but unfortunately perhaps a little bit short on conditioning, according to trainer Aidan O'Brien, who was quoted as saying, to be fair to Dylan Thomas, for him to turn up at all was a big if. So he clearly had some hesitation about the horse's condition. In contrast, of course, the connections of Dr. Dino are very surprised and pleasantly surprised, certainly, at an outstanding performance by their horse, who was already a Grade 1 winner here in the United States. Dr. Dino's trained in France by Richard Gibson and was ridden to victory by Olivier Pellier. A son of Moutathir from Logica picks up the win under the international riding star Olivier Pellier in 2 minutes 28. And one. We'll continue now in the Cathay Pacific Hong Kong Mile, $2.1 million, about 1 mile on the turf.
And ready now, racing, and a lovely line out of the gates. Floral Pegasus jumped nicely, so did the grade downtown. Now Congo Rikishio was a little bit tardy, but he's quickly picking up the ground. And as expected, Congo Rikishio races to the early lead from the Duke. Downtown third, Able One improves on the fence, and deeper out Floral Pegasus. Visionario's handy in a midfield position inside Darjeena, and Krakador improves. Excellent Art's gone back down to the fence in front of the favourite Good Baba, then Joyful Winner from Spirito del Vento, and the British runner El Kazi drops down to the tail of the field. 25-2 the lead section. Congo Rikishio is not going overly hard in the lead, out by a length and a half to Downtown and Able One. Floral Pegasus having no luck. He's caught off the track. Three deep around the Duke and Visionario. Deeper out then is Krakador endeavouring to improve from Darjeena. Excellent Art on the fence. Good Baba creeping closer. Further back to Joyful Winner, Spirito del Vento, and Alkazi sees them all as they travel to the turn. And Fujita has rated the leader here perfectly at the moment, Congo Rikishio. It's been an uncontested lead from Downtown and Able One. Then off the course, Floral Pegasus, the Duke shaken up from Visionario. Krakador's about to pull out. Good Baba goes with him, and Excellent Art stands them a big start. Darjeena needs luck to filly. She hasn't got much room. Floral Pegasus races up the Congo Rikishio, but quickly Good Baba and Krakador stake their claims. Good Baba getting to the front from Krakador. Back on the inside, Floral Pegasus and Darjeena. It's Good Baba in front. Krakador, if the game, he's coming at it. Good Baba hangs on. Just Good Barbara half head to Krakador. Darjeena third. Then Floral Pegasus, joyful winner. Spirito Del.
Good Baba, a horse that was very successful in mile performances over in Asia throughout the course of the early portion of the year, and came back with yet another outstanding performance here to pick up the win over Craik Edouard, who was in from the Godolphin operation carrying the blue silks, represented by, of course, Frankie Dettori and Saeed bin Saror, representing Sheikh Mohammed's organization. Darjeena, a horse that I earlier in the season thought would make a spectacular Breeders' Cup mile horse, did run well to finish third, a three-year-old filly taking on an outstanding group of horses in this field. And I really did think that she was a sensation this year as a miler in Europe. Perhaps a little bit of a difficult trip for a European to make, just because of the fact that their major season pretty much ends at the end of September, the beginning of October, and as a result, it was kind of a little bit of a downtime for her, but I thought she handled the shipping very, very well, finishing a very solid third. The winner, Good Baba, who has been very, very solid throughout the course of this year, coming into this in very good form for great connections, picks up the win in 1:35.2. We'll wrap things up with the Cathay Pacific Hong Kong Cup, 1.25 miles this time. On the turf course, three-year-olds and up, $2.6 million.
Intriguing race to the first turn, and they're all set, racing in the cup, and a good line out of the gates, and getting the best of the start was Shadow Gate. He's going to lead initially. Romonti's out well, and so's Royal Prince on the outside. Del Pesce is snagging Vengeance of Rain back to last. It's Shadow Gate leading out of the straight from Royal Prince, is looking to head him off. Romonti in third, and Dettori keeps him away from the fence in the early part. Viva Pataka's gone to the rails. Shadow Gate the outside. Music away the outside. Then Vengeance of Rain and Art Trader is last. Royal Prince didn't handle that turn particularly well. The Preble's been able to balance him up now and get him down to the fence. It's Royal Prince leading to the back by a length on Shadow Gate. Romonti's travelling keen in third. Music away fourth. Viva Vataka snatched up in a pocket, but travels well for Canaan in fifth. Two further back to Vengeance of Rain, and Art Trader is last. So it's one of the long hopes for Hong Kong. It's Royal Prince at his first try in open company, leading out by two lengths to Shadow Gate. Two further back to Romonti, who still travels hard on the steel. Music away fourth around Viva Pataka. Two off to Vengeance of Rain, and Art Trader is last. 27.6 was the lead section, 24.8, and it's Royal Prince making the running in the Hong Kong Cup by a length and a half to Shadow Gate. Romonti just coming off the heels in third position. Viva Pataka gets closer in fourth. Then Music Away the outside. A length and a half to Art Trader. And Vengeance of Rain sees them all as they race to the final bend. And Shadow Gate applies pressure now to Royal Prince before the bend. Romotti's tracking up behind Shadow Gate into third. Viva Pataka quietly ridden. Now Canaan just starts to feel for him in fourth. Then Music Away. Vengeance of Rain shaken up. And Art Trader's last as they turn into the straight. And Shadow Gate races to the lead. But Romotti's giving chase. And Viva Pataka's going between runners. Vengeance of Rain gives away an impossible start as Dettori takes Romonti to the front. Viva Pataka's asked to go after him. Romonti cuts back to the fence. Viva Pataka, he's trying to cut him back. It's Romonti in front. Viva Pataka gets within a half, but Dettori won't let Romonti stop, and Romonti wins the cup from again Viva Pataka. Music Away ran third. Then Art Trader, Shadow Gate, Vengeance of...
Romonti, another horse that I thought had Breeders' Cup aspirations. They decided to try something a little bit different with this horse, who was a monstrous miler in Europe this year. And in a fairly short field, Romonti picks up the victory here for the Godolphin operation, trained by, of course, Saeed bin Saror. It was a little bit of a tense time there, as there was a steward's inquiry called after the runner-up appeared to be short of room when Romonti took the lead a furlong out. Mick Kennan, who was aboard Viva Pataka, who in very good news, that it sounds like he is going to have another international campaign next year that may bring him to the United States. But Mick Kennan placed an objection, but the stewards did not take action against Romonti. Frankie Dettori had him very well placed in third place in the early going and sent him along. The five-year-old son made a nice move to get the first run on Viva Pataka, and that rival was not quite able to get back into the run and finished a half length behind. Musical Way, completing the order of the top three, is another international sensation, a horse that I've been following throughout the year. Vengeance of Rain, disappointed, finishing sixth in the relatively short field of seven. Ramonti is a five-year-old son of Martino Alonso from Fosca. He is owned, of course, by Godolphin Racing, trained by Saeed Bin Soror and ridden to victory by Frankie Dettori. Ramonti covers the about distance at Sha Tin in 2:02 and 4. That'll wrap up this edition of the International Horses and Courses. Thank you very much for having joined us. We hope you've enjoyed the program. I'd like to issue a special thank you to Dan Hayes, who compiled a lot of information here for me to go over before putting this program together. Also gathering up all of the races and putting them together for you so that you'll be able to see them all. In the appropriate order is Pete Persico, who is going to be taking care of all of the production work. And certainly thank both of those gentlemen for their help in getting this and all of these international agencies together for you. Thanks very much for watching. We'll see you back here next time.
If you have any comments or suggestions, please write to the general manager at the OTV Television Network, 510 Smith Street, Schenectady, New York, 12305.
This is the OTV Network.